Hey, it's Weather Bill. This video is about the New Jerusalem, the city of God that's coming to the earth. Now, when we read in Scripture of the New Jerusalem being called the Holy City, in our minds we conjure up imaginations of some kind of glorious city that will be in Israel. But that's not what the Scripture teaches. Scripture teaches us that the Holy City, the New Jerusalem, is going to be much, much bigger than we ever had imagined. So, let's look at the humongous size of this place. It's going to be our inheritance. We read of the size of the holy city in Revelation 21:16, and the city lieth four square, and the length is as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with the reed, 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height of it are equal. So in other words, this scripture says the city, really the size of a country, will be four squared. Its length, width, and height will be the same, 12,000 furlongs. So what is a furlong? Let's look it up. Here in a Google search, we read of a furlong being 0.125 miles. So translated, 12,000 furlongs is 1,500 miles. All I can say is, wow, 1,500 miles long by 1,500 miles wide. That's not a city, that's a country. This is how big the holy city is compared to the U.S. So when the scripture calls it the holy city, it's really a country, or as some call it, the holy nation. This is how big it would look if its center was in Jerusalem. But listen, what many people do not realize is this city is also 1,500 miles high. And that is what I want to cover here, because its height, the height of the holy city, is what's even more amazing. Picture the holy city having floors or layers. And if we give those floors 1,000-foot high ceilings on average, it would be as though each floor of the city had its own sky. To put it into perspective, the tallest building here in the LA skyline is just over 1,000 feet high. I mean, how much sky do you need when you also have access to the heavens in our new celestial body that will be given to us? Now, if we have 1,000-foot high ceilings with a 1,500-mile high city, how many floors or layers would that make? If 1 mile is 5,280 feet, and we take 5,280 feet times 1,500 miles high, that's 7.92 million feet. And divided by 1,000-foot high ceilings, we come to 7,920 1,000-foot high layers of 1,500 square miles. Maybe we could subtract the 12 feet thick floors and come to a little over 7,800 layers. Now take those 7,800 layers and try to spread them flat throughout the earth. If all of the earth was landmass and no oceans, with the earth being 197 million square miles, with the holy city being 2.25 million square miles, we would come to 87.5 holy city layers to cover the entire earth. But the holy city is 7,800 layers. So 7,800 layers divided into 87.5 equals 89 planet Earths of landmass. Oh. 89 planet Earths of landmass. I think that will be enough room for a few billion saints. When a person first enters the New Jerusalem, they will ask, How do I get to the middle of the city to see the king? One of us there will reply, oh, you go out about 750 miles to downtown, or it's only 750 miles to city center. Now that's just on the first floor. If you want to get to the center of the city, go down about 750 miles and then head up another 750 miles and you're there. There will be no cars or buses in the holy city. There will be streets of gold. But much of the holy city will be grassy walkways and more of a natural, nature-type, very beautiful setting everywhere. like you see here in these pictures, only 10 times better than this. Now the numbers I presented here are uniform, but the Holy City will not be uniform like that. There may be certain floors of the Holy City that are not 1,000 feet, some higher than others, you know, some floors 20 foot high, some floors 2,000 feet high. But now, let's see how many people can fit comfortably into 89 planet Earths of landmass. If in these last days we have 1 billion Christians who overcome, and then add in about 2 or 3 more billion saints throughout the ages who overcome as well, we might have a total of 3 to 4 billion saints in the Holy City. If this is the case, we could speculate a bit and then add up and divide the acreage of 89 planet Earths of space to see how many acres of land each of us may inherit. If there is 640 acres in a square mile, and one Earth of total landmass equals 197 million square miles, this would give us 126 billion acres of land. Now, since the New Jerusalem layers of land could be 89 times that in landmass, this would equal approximately 11.2 trillion acres divided by 4 billion people. This would give each person close to 2,800 acres of land. All I can say is, wow, that is some major prime real estate to be had. I'd be glad to be a martyr for Jesus to have that, because 2,800 acres in this life, you can't have that unless you're a money slave or you're born into it. And besides, why would I invest in land here down on this filthy planet when I can have the best of it all up there? Now, Scripture is very serious about only certain people that will be allowed to even enter into the city. In Revelation 21:27, we read, "And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination, or make a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's Book of Life." Scripture also says in 1 Corinthians 6:9, "Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind." In other words, live a clean life before God, and then you will be a part of the Holy City, our real, everlasting home. Not these brick and wooden boxes we call houses, which get us in debt, break down, and cost us a lot of money in utility bills. In the Holy City, the New Jerusalem, there is no bills, just a debt of love to pay the Master. And that debt of love is to do His commands, to love one another, and to live clean before Him. If you want to become a citizen of the Holy City and receive honor from the King, you will be despised by the secular people of this world, whose house, lives, and cities are perishing. But if you want to be a citizen of the everlasting glory to come, then come and allow Jesus Christ to be the director of your life. That means committing to follow Jesus Christ in all you do. Now, this life is but a test. The more you are tested with trials and tribulations and pass those tests, the greater will be your reward in the Holy City. No one who has it easy in this life is tested much, so they are not proven faithful, and will that much less be rewarded in eternity. That includes you televangelists getting fat off the money that was supposed to go to help the people. So rejoice when you are being put to the test by the troubles of this life. As you remain faithful, it will be to your glory and to your credit when that everlasting reward comes.